The horses are now ready for the third race.
Yeah. Well, it's for 2-year-olds going the distance of 6 furlongs. Number 1 is Pewter Fool, owned by the Balmain Stable. Number 2 is Simple Millions, owned by the Calgary Cattle Company. Number 3 is Seagull, owned by Charles Armstrong and trained by Ann Witch. Ladies and gentlemen, that's now my husband's time.
Daddy.
How many times do I gotta tell you? I do the betting. Now tell me what you got and get out of here.
400 to win on Pewter Force and 100 to place on Seagull. And I want you to give me 35 to bet on Pewter Force myself.
You know the rules. Runners only get to place bets for the customers.
Since when did Eddie the Book care about rules? Trust me, Pewter Force is gonna win. Eddie, you know I need the money.
This better stay between you and me, kid. Your dad wouldn't like it if he knew I was lending you money.
He'd like it even less if he knew you were always using my tips. Not again. I gotta go, Eddie. Don't forget to bet on Pewter Force.
Out of our way, please.
Do it, Casey.
Come on, Dave.
He's moving as fast as I can.
Guys at the station are gonna love this thing.
Reggie.
Why?
Shut up.
These words I'm saying, prayers I'm praying, get lonely when
Don't let the wood cut into a wound that hurts when the blood runs thin. Don't give too much too soon, cause they'll take it all, leave your heart in ruins. Cause I gave you answers to love without tons of a lost, a lonely question, but what did we
of another beautiful day here in CFAC country. Our weatherman tells me we're going to have sunshine all day long. Looks like a good day to go to the park. Before you do that, make sure that you stick around, because in a minute we're going to be giving away the entire works of Merle Haggard on CD. It'll be part of our contest coming up, a regular contest here on CFAC.
Mr. Armstrong, we've been instructed to give you as much information as possible.
Is there anything else I should know about?
That was 6 months ago. Pascal was in juvenile court at the time, and she, well, she isn't fully aware of the details. Look, if you're having second thoughts about taking Pascal on as a foster child, we better deal with it right now.
Life without challenges isn't worth much, you know. My wife used to say that. Whatever. No child should have to suffer for a father's mistakes. Okay.
Hi. Picked the right horse again yesterday? We missed you last night. I guess in all the excitement, you forgot you were supposed to leave with your prospective father?
No, I didn't. I have a father. I don't need a part-time one.
Honey, this isn't easy for any of us. But we don't have a choice here.
I want to live on my own.
No, you do, but you can't. Until you're 16, you've got to live in a group home or with a foster parent.
Dad'll be out in a couple of months.
Mm-hmm. And how long is he going to be out for this time? 2 months? 4 months? Pascal, you are still too young to be on your own. Not much point in us going through all this again, is there? I've packed most of your things for you. You know, it might make a better impression on your new father if you changed your clothes.
He's not my father, Ms. Redding.
Thank you. bad for your teeth.
Miss Redding and I have arranged for your papers to be transferred to your new school.
I think that's a little loud.
Might as well be able to hear it.
Well, the ranch is pretty self-contained.
Holy, what the hell do you think you're doing?
Clancy, it was my fault. I thought one...
I asked you guys to get that horse ready for shipping. Now what? Well, don't just stand there. Go get him.
Yes, sir. Since we're already in trouble, how about we give that horse another minute?
You'll never get away with this.
Yes, I can. I'm gonna tell you. Norman, just keep up. You don't want to get hurt. Come on, baby. Norman, back to the
road. What's going on? Why are they chasing that horse?
It's Clancy's horse. He must have got away.
Who's Clancy?
City girls sure have fancy ways of getting out of cars. Hope you don't ride horses the same way.
Pascal, this is Ann Williams and Pascal Draney.
Everyone calls me Trainer. Nice to meet you.
Gotta watch her, Pascal. She runs the place.
Sweet kid. Pascal, welcome to Armstrong Ranches. Let's get you unpacked.
After you.
Rosa will get your bags.
Follow me. Hi, Rosa.
Hi. Oh,
why'd you bring home such a skinny one?
Well, if we don't overfeed her, she's apparently good for a couple of years.
Never mind. I've got lots of experience with chicken arms like these.
I can wait for dinner.
Come on, run up to Clancy's room.
Tell Clancy I'm making his favorite dinner tonight.
Hi.
Checked your room. Everything seems to be fine. See you later.
Thanks. This is your room up here. This is Clancy's room.
So this is what you selected to keep me company.
Pascal, this is my son, Clancy. Clancy, this is Pascal.
Now, the ride from town was pretty dry. Why don't you offer Pascal something to drink, huh? Well, I'm going to go check on Sagal, let you two get acquainted.
I don't really need the company.
I mean, as you can see, I have everything I need to keep me occupied and entertained.
Pascal was at the racetrack yesterday. You never know, she might have some inside information for you.
By the looks of her, it'd be extremely accurate, too.
When you've finished your drink, come on downstairs. I'll have a trainer show you around. You gonna join us for dinner?
Maybe you should talk to Polly while you're out there. It seems that he can't comprehend simple tasks these days.
Well, I'm sure that if you'd made more specific arrangements, it could have been handled properly, huh? I hope you realize how hard this is for Polly.
Why'd he pick you?
Beats me. When you've been in one foster home, you've been in them all. Everyone has a different reason for taking you in.
Guess there wasn't much to choose from.
Listen.
What are you staring at? Haven't you seen a wheelchair before?
I've reached the Eddie residence. I hope you have something of eloquence to say because you're bothering me at a real crucial time here.
It's me, Pascal.
You sure lost those cops, kid. Your dad would have been proud.
Eddie, listen. How much did I make? I need money, fast.
Well, kid, geez, with everything going on and all that confusion, I barely had time to place a quarter of what you wanted.
And you know she owed me some from before. What can I say?
Damn it, Eddie. I paid you back everything that my dad owes you.
They put me on a stupid dude ranch to babysit some guy in a wheelchair.
I gotta get out of here. Eddie.
If I can get back to town, can I stay with you till Dad gets out?
Hey, kid, you know I've been like a second father to you, but I gotta be leaving town for a couple of days. Maybe check out Santa Anita. Maybe when I get back, we'll hit the track again, though, okay?
Eddie, I can't stay here.
Kid, how bad can a few weeks in the country be? You'll pull through. You always do.
Look, I promise.
As soon as I get back, I'll call you.
Eddie! Eddie!
Thank you.
killed him still.
Mr. Armstrong, can we please give him more time?
Sorry, Pauly. We don't have a choice.
This will only take a minute.
Easy, boy.
Oh,
easy.
Whoa.
What are you doing to that horse?
Oh, my God, you're killing him.
Pascal, this doesn't concern you. I'd like you to go back to the house.
I'm not going back to the house. I want you to drive me back to town. Now. I've heard of getting rid of horses with drugs.
I'm reporting you all to the SPCA for cruelty. For cruelty to animals. I should have known you rich guys just think you can get away with anything.
Let Lady, go. Miss Redding told me you'd be a handful, but I thought you'd wait at least 24 hours before starting trouble.
Gail didn't tell me you'd go around killing horses.
You and I are going to get something straight here. See, I'm the boss. And the next time I tell you something is none of your business, I want you to walk away from it.
Well,
I want you to go upstairs, clean up, and I'll see you for dinner. Go on.
Little chicken, it is better if you eat faster. Everything is getting cold. Mr. Armstrong, if that's all, I think Polly and I should go home now.
Oh, please thank Polly for me, Rosa. Good night.
Good night. See you in the morning, Bambina.
If I'm still here.
You should be so lucky.
Is the horse dead?
No. They just gave him something to calm him down so he'd be easier to handle.
Why?
To be taken away.
Where?
Primo Baby has a...
Don't call him Primo Baby.
Polly named him. Primo means first in Italian.
He has a congenital eye weakness. Clancy wanted to put him to sleep when he was born, but Polly said he'd look after him.
And it's gotten worse. To the point that he now has less than 20% vision. And the vet only gives him a few months before he'll be blind.
So you're moving him to a new ranch.
Boy, are you fast. He's going to the slaughterhouse.
What? You can't kill an animal because he's going blind.
The horse belongs to Clancy, so it's his decision.
Sure. But you let Polly convince you that he could look after him. We wouldn't be going through this now if he had just been put to sleep when he was born.
Clancy, this happened right after your accident. We all felt you just needed some more time.
How come you didn't tell me I was coming here to babysit Clancy?
Needs the company of somebody his own age.
So a foster child was cheaper than hiring someone?
No. I thought about it a long time. An addition to this family is what I wanted.
Well, they both need time to adjust. She'll get into something. Sorry about Primo.
I know. It just doesn't seem fair.
You all right about tomorrow?
I wish I hadn't fought so hard to keep this stupid horse alive when he was born.
Well, when you love something, it's hard to let it go.
I wanted him to spend tonight out in the open. It's kind of his last night of freedom. I didn't want him cooped up in some damn still all night.
I'll stay on one condition.
Well, don't wait until you're invited or anything.
I've agreed to stay and turn you into a human being if your father gives me a horse.
So you've fallen for it. A pawn in my father's hand. And what's he going to give you? Some quarter horse that's not even line bred?
What's line bred?
It means a horse has similar ancestors for at least four generations. If a horse doesn't have a strong family tree, he can't be considered a top-notch thoroughbred. And thoroughbreds are the only ones that count on a racetrack. The horse my father is going to give you probably has no similar ancestors. In other words, he's going to give you a plow horse.
Why can't you ever trust a rich guy? What about Primo Baby?
He's not an issue.
Bet your machine can't give me any information on Primo.
Primo's father, Haley's Dancer, was line bred all the way back to Northern Dancer. He was the first Canadian bred horse to win the Kentucky Derby in 1964, and he is still one of the world's most successful sires.
So you mean that Primo Baby has both speed and spirit?
You bet. It was one of my first experiments. I had to watch for the dominance and recessives in order to control those weaknesses and strengths. It took me almost a year to match these pedigrees. Father made his money in oil. Well, I want to make mine by being as good a breeder as the man who bred Northern Dancer.
So you mean that if Primo didn't have this eye defect, he could be as good as Seygold?
I mean he better. Yeah, but this is illogical reasoning. The horse was born defective and should have been put to sleep right away. Now my father can spend his days referring to my computer breeding as a catastrophe. Who cares?
You don't want me on this ranch any more than I want to be here, right?
I'm listening.
I promise to go away permanently, if you win.
What am I betting?
What are you doing with that horse?
I'm saying goodbye to a friend. And if you don't mind, I'd like to do it alone.
Yeah, I'll crash the truck.
Morning, Polly.
Morning, Pascal. Let's get him loaded up.
Wait! He's my horse now. I had Clancy put it in writing.
This is ridiculous.
Last night, I agreed to stay on one condition. That you give me my own horse. Primo is the one I want.
All right. Since the horse belongs to Clancy, I have to honor this wager. But I want you to understand one thing. This is very serious business. That horse is going to be your responsibility. Give you 48 hours to come up with a plan.
I already have a plan. I'm going to race him. And Polly has agreed to help me train him.
What?
I mean it, Pascal. If that horse is mistreated in any way, I'd be taken away without notice. Understand?
Yes.
I hope so.
I don't know whether to kill you or to hug you.
Keep your distance.
I owe you one for saving Primo.
You can begin by telling me what's going on around here.
Primo and I can tell you anything you want to know. I've got two horses left to exercise. Why don't you take one of them?
Your eyes.
Patch is at her litter.
She had them hidden a long time.
Oh, he's so cute. You know, I still remember when Mom and Dad brought her home. I used to chase her all over. Dad still isn't too thrilled about Sakegold's time, is he?
Well, I'm gonna have a good long talk with that man.
Good luck.
There you go. Thanks.
Hey. Pascal, I've been informed I'm giving you a ride to school.
Let me get my stuff.
Polly. You got my money? This is all I gave you. Where the hell are my winnings?
Clancy, I told you I wouldn't bet for you.
Then why did you take the money?
You insisted. Besides, I knew if I had it, you couldn't give it to someone else to gamble for you.
Hey, Clance. How about you and I clearing up that little deal after school?
Get lost, Rob.
Hey, hold on, guys.
I don't want you to expect this kind of treatment every morning. I'll take you to the office, then you're on your own.
Just your signature on this one. That's the last one. Pascal. Mr. Armstrong and Ms. Redding filled in most of these for you. Here is your classroom schedule. I am curious about something, though.
My mother died when I was born. My grandmother named me Pascal because it was Easter. My father's in jail. Could be out on good behavior any day now.
You didn't think it was important?
Well, it's not exactly contagious.
No, but it can be hereditary.
I said it was none of your business.
Your father is a convict.
Anybody in the world left to tell? To think that Alexander Graham Bell did all that work to invent the telephone when he could have simply waited for you.
It's over there. This is her first day class. How about taking a break from being such a jerk?
Could it be that horses and women just aren't your best bet? If I were you, I'd start to think about that interest that keeps mounting.
By the time you pay that sleaze off, you're gonna owe him the ranch. Tell your dad and get it over with.
Keep this up. I was looking for Polly.
I live here. Polly and Rosa live at the bottom of the hill.
I'll never get this place figured out. It's bigger than the city. Why do you live here?
Peace. Privacy. I've lived in the city. You write your dad often?
Every day.
He writes you back?
Nah. Says he's too busy. You know, there's a lot to do in jail.
Teach you anything about horses?
Mostly about betting.
Maybe you could use some help training Primo.
Guess that would depend on who was asking. Clancy refuses to let Polly help me.
Well, it'll be almost impossible without Polly. He practically raised that animal after Clancy abandoned him. Maybe I could give you some time.
You?
I started riding horses when I was 3. My parents sent me all over the world. Finally, I just got fed up with all the glitz and all the travel. And when Charles offered me that job of master trainer and ranch manager, I was scared. But I took it.
You'd rather have one of the wranglers give you a hand.
When do we start?
When you agree that I'm the boss and what I say goes. No questions asked.
Everybody loves giving orders around here.
Meet me at the barn, 5:30 tomorrow morning. You're late.
I thought this place was rich enough to have janitors.
The most important thing you learn about training a horse are its habits. And one of a horse's habits is that it shits on a regular basis. And they were born smart enough to know they can just walk away from it. Let's go. You shake it, you dump it. A good horsewoman has to know her horse, her equipment, and herself. First we train you, then we train the horse.
Train me? What happened to training Primo?
Riding a horse anyone can do. Learning what makes him tick is something else. Primo won't let you get anywhere near his back until he gets to know you. Since he's going blind, it'll take a bit longer. So, in the meantime, scrub his gear.
Girl.
Is that a girl?
Come
single?
On, say gold.
Yes.
What we got?
That's fantastic. Oh, she's right on schedule.
Your father has got to believe that computer stuff by now.
Oh, yeah, sure he does. And Norm, now let's cool her down.
But Polly and I timed say gold yesterday. She's doing great.
Yeah, by whose standards?
You agreed that you wouldn't interfere with my training program. Look. It's right there. She's right on schedule. In a few weeks, she will be in prime condition for the Calgary Cup.
Come on, Clancy. Some things you have to do on instinct. You can't rely on this thing to make all your decisions.
There was no possible way to see the congenital eye weakness in Primo. The computer program and the information I retrieved were sound.
Yeah, so sound we still have a blind thoroughbred in our hands.
You're the one that told Pascal she could have a horse if she stayed.
That's not what I'm worried about.
No? What is it, then? Does my gambling remind you too much of Mother?
All right. You got 2 weeks. If Seagull's time doesn't improve, we won't even bother entering her in the cup.
I tried like crazy.
looks like you could use a ride home. I go right past the Armstrong Ranch.
Do you really own Pewter Force?
Well, just technically my father owns it. Why?
Sure. You can give me a ride home.
We've all had a share of broken hearts.
What's going, Rob?
Broken hearts and our broken dreams. They always lead us back to seeing, yeah. There's no time to lose now. We can't turn back. I dreamt you would see things my way. After tonight, babe, I hope you'll stay. Remember me. Always remember me.
I'll walk from here.
Are you sure?
Yeah.
Did Robbie Baby make you walk?
You creep! Someday I'm gonna wipe that smirk right off his face.
See, Clancy left you in the dust again.
Can you believe it? How can anybody be so immature?
Seems to me I only ate crazy things like that when some man got me very angry.
Some days I don't think he's human.
Getting left home with Rob had nothing to do with it?
Why would it? Clancy hates giving me rides to school.
Exactly.
Why can't guys be normal? They don't talk unless you force them. They can't have fun unless you invent it. And if something goes wrong, they always blame somebody else. And you can never count on them.
Oh, so it isn't just Clancy. Still no letter from your father?
Look what you made me do. I forgot the tuna. Polly, what is it with Clancy and Rob?
It's a long story.
Clancy hates Rob.
He's got his reasons. Whenever I get crazy about Clancy and the things he does, I come out and sit in that for a while.
Why should you care how he feels, the way he treats you?
Clancy and I were real tight 2 years ago. The only thing we fought about was Rob.
You don't like Rob either?
I don't exactly travel in his circles. I just know things about him he doesn't want me to know.
What changed?
Didn't Mr. Armstrong tell you anything about Clancy?
No.
Clancy and his mother rolled the car. His mother never made it.
And Clancy ended up in a wheelchair.
I talked too much. Primo and Sagold were born in the same week. Clancy couldn't even bring himself to touch Primo. I gotta go. God.
Okay, Primo. Just one more time, then you and I get serious. Tomorrow we start all over again.
All this training is paying off. I'm impressed. What can I say?
Get lost!
Found this in our library last night. Thought you might find it useful for training Primo.
Thanks. But my horse training days are over.
Smart girl. At least you know when to give up. Not like some people I know. Catch you later.
Ain't he just the most gorgeous, grandest thing ever set a girl's heart to flutter?
Well, at least he's trying to be a friend. Which is more than I can say for some people.
You need a friend like Rob, like a rattlesnake needs a gun.
Well, at least he's taking me to the horseman's benefit.
That's the social event of the year. I'd be the first one they'd lock out.
And you'd be the second.
Ah, go soak snit lips.
The only reason he invited you to that ball is to get information. You just stay quiet about Say Gold.
Just when I thought you two were starting to get along.
Your heart goes far away. A romance only breaks you when you're lying awake. All alone, I never let you know how I felt inside, so I let you go. When two hearts are never meet, the love that you make me feel. Now that you're gone, the love feels so wrong.
I'll always show you a good time, Pascal. I'll pick you up in a couple of hours.
Okay. Bye.
What are you doing, man?
Well, someone's got to do it.
That's the fourth time this week.
Why don't you get one of the hands to feed him?
Everyone on this ranch is already doing more than his fair share.
Well, almost everyone. Did you and Rob have a good time?
I never promised to spend every day of my life with Primo.
It was your deal, Pascal. You fought to be able to train Primo. I guess you just didn't realize it was going to be a full-time job.
What's the difference? I wasn't getting anywhere with him. At least Rob shows me a good time.
Oh, a good time.
Well, at least some appreciation.
Pascal, didn't it make you feel good inside knowing you were accomplishing something with Primo?
I wasn't getting anywhere. Clancy said I should never have come here. And he was right.
Wrong. We want you here, Pascal. I told you, if that horse wasn't being looked after, he'd have to go. Now, what you do to compensate for your social life is another matter.
I tried. It just wasn't working. I don't owe any of you anything. I'm going to the horseman's benefit.
Your heart goes far away. A romance only breaks you when you're lying awake.
I thought we were going to the horseman's ball.
You don't mind, do you? The last thing I wanted to do this evening was spend time with a bunch of old fogies. Never been on a merry-go-round before?
Sure I have.
I can't believe Mr. Armstrong let you go out with me this evening.
Charles can't tell me what to do.
I didn't mean Charles.
Clancy? Why would he care?
I guarantee you, Clancy doesn't like the idea of you being with me.
Well, they're all so uptight around there these days. I'm sure they're just happy for me to be out with anybody.
What's the matter? Clancy getting antsy about the Calgary Cup?
No, it's me. I'm not taking care of Primo Baby properly.
I don't know why they didn't get rid of him a long time ago. Spend their time on something more valuable, like, say, gold.
Are you serious? That's all Clancy ever talks about. He's got our entire menu on computer.
Time improving any?
You weren't planning to take me to the horseman's ball, were you?
Of course I was.
You didn't want to be seen with me, did you?
Well, you are a bit different. But that has nothing to do with it.
Clancy was right. You were using me just to find out about Seagold.
Come on, Pascal, grow up. Everybody uses everybody.
Well, if that's growing up, I never want to do it. Take me home. Now!
So how was your date?
You're beautiful.
Thanks for waiting up, Clance. I'll take care of the hall light.
Warned a number of times, and you refused to look after him, so he became a burden.
Now, in that situation, I have no choice.
So if someone makes one mistake, she wears it the rest of her life? No wonder Clancy's so screwed up. You've never forgiven him for Primo's blindness.
Let's just leave Clancy out of this.
Well, he's in it. It's not just me you're upset with. Why don't you send Clancy away as well? Then I'll be gone too, and you won't have to deal with any handicaps.
I'm sorry, there's nothing I can do.
Well, I'm going to get Primo. Are you going to take me, or should I hitchhike?
Do it the day the horse is brought in. I tell you, if that horse is alive, we're gonna make some changes.
Don't you feel love for anything?
Love isn't just a whole lot of talk, you know. It also means action, responsibility.
I know all I wanted before was a good time. I've never had a rich boy even look at me before this. I just didn't realize how much I love Primo.
Sorry, folks, you'll have to come back in the morning. Office opens at 8.
Have you done Primo Baby yet?
Never heard of him. Look, the animals are all gone.
Let's go.
No!
What the heck? Look out!
Careful! Stop!
Get all this mud off you. You'll be okay.
Pascal, bring him over and we'll get him started.
You read my magic mind.
Sorry, Pascal, I didn't mean to wake you.
Where am I? Oh, I didn't mean to fall asleep and stay over.
That's all right. Want some juice?
Nah. I'll just finish this book and go.
Pascal, I didn't expect you to become an expert in a couple of months. I didn't think there was a book left to read.
I'll never catch up to Polly or Clancy or you, will I?
Well, you will if you want to. You stay focused.
You mean stay away from men?
That we're all just men like Rob. Sometimes when we need attention, we just go looking for it in the wrong place.
How come... how come you and Charles...
aren't together?
Yeah.
Well... Charles is a wonderful man. But he was married when I got hired. And when his wife died, he just... wanted a friend. Someone to help him through the pain. Someone to help with Clancy. Maybe in time.
But that was 2 years ago.
Well, to you, that may seem like an eternity. To me, it just feels like a couple of months. Let's go feed the horses.
Trainer. How do you know when you're on the right track?
Different for everyone. To me, it was making the commitment to something I really believed in. Pascal, anytime you want to get away from the big house, you're more than welcome to stay here.
Thanks.
Norman! Push her! That's it, Zangold! Yeah. Yes! Yes! Come on, Primo! Yeah.
What the hell does she think she's doing?
She's just proving that Primo can be a racer. That's what you bred him for.
She's crazy.
Hey, Clancy, how about letting up a little?
Polly, just concentrate on Zangold.
Oh, look, it's not just for Pascal, it's for you.
Look, no, forget it, Polly, we don't have time.
Hey. If Primo has a ghost of a chance and you don't do something to help, you're gonna regret it for the rest of your life. Oh! Look, just a few pointers. It won't take more than 1 hour on that computer of yours.
All right. 1 hour of computer time. But I need his latest stats, his menu, his heart rate, his aerobic count, his stride length.
Whew, yeah.
So, who's behind this breeding? Charles Armstrong?
No, his son, Clancy.
Oh, and now you've got him. And you're entering him into the Calgary Cup.
Yeah. Thanks.
Wait. You've forgotten to put the jockey's name down.
Yeah.
Well, who's the regular jockey?
He's got a very difficult name to pronounce. I'll get the correct spelling and bring it back to you.
Check up on this one.
I got a call late last night from the race office.
Oh, yeah?
Yeah, it seems as though someone went ahead and registered me to ride Primo at the Calgary Cup.
Well, I didn't exactly have a chance to tell you yesterday.
Mm-hmm.
I was going to tell you today at school.
Well, it doesn't make much difference anyways. They called to tell me I couldn't do it because they found out the horse was blind.
But I didn't tell anyone that I'd registered. I didn't even tell Charles or Clancy. Besides, he's going blind. He's not blind yet.
I know it was Rob Bowman. He just wants to cut down the competition.
I'm sorry, Polly. You're just the only person I trusted to ride Primo.
Well, who knows? I might have got my picture on the cover of Sports Illustrated. See you in school.
We'll have an interview later in the program with Lanny McDonald. Good news for all you Flames fans. Before a packed house, the Calgary Flames dethroned the LA Kings last night in a high-scoring 7-5 battle. Tim Hunter led the scoring with a dramatic second-period hat trick.
That fundraising event will be held in Okotoks Arena tonight at 7 p.m. The Disabled Association of Calgary may be interested in our next story. Seems prejudice can move into the world of animals. A local girl tried to register a horse called Primo Baby in the $200,000 Calgary Cup. Pascal Draney told Calgary media today that the racing secretary has thrown the horse out of the race due to his poor eyesight.
Our open line will be taking calls on your thoughts on the Primo Baby issue. We've been trying to reach Pascal Draney all day long, and the racing secretary is not available for comment. But we're going to try the best we can to get a hold of them and bring the latest story to you.
Shit.
Pascal?
Yes?
Why are you doing this to me? Why are you trying to make a spectacle out of me?
I'm trying to do just what it says.
What's the point of entering him in the Calgary Cup? I mean, did you really think that they were going to let you race a blind horse?
He's not blind yet.
No, he just can't see in front of his face.
If Seygold's beside him, he doesn't need to see. He'll stay with her.
No. Oh, no, you don't. You can do anything you like with Primo, but over my dead body, are you going to screw up Seygold?
Have any idea how harmful this is to everything we've tried to build here?
Well, if nothing else, this little episode certainly has you two agreeing. Neither of you want to give Primo a chance to win. I mean, what if he won? Then somebody here would have to live up to his potential.
What is the percentage of racing a horse you know is going to lose?
I can say he tried. He deserves a chance before it's too late.
This is not Save a Handicap Week.
We're all handicapped. Some of us just show it on the outside more than others.
Clancy, wait. If we're going to make it as a family, we've got to stop taking each other for granted.
Work. He's not responding fast enough, and he won't extend his stride.
Well, we'll just have to train day and night. Pascal, any little thing you know about Primo could really help Polly.
Well, mostly talking to him and tapping him with your boots is all he needs. If you want him to speed up, you just tell him to go faster and stroke his neck. Patting his shoulder slows him down.
Simple. Why didn't I know that? Anything else you forgot to tell me?
If you touch his tail, he does the Latin hustle.
Come on.
Come on, you guys.
Now just hold Seygold back.
If you want to extend his stride, just lean forward. believe the racing secretary is still gonna test Primo?
You've got a few hours. You could cancel the test.
But I won't.
Father, Son, Holy Ghost.
Why'd you do that?
Because, my crazy friend, if we're gonna race Primo, we need all the help we can get. Come on.
This morning, the racing secretary, in reaction to a lot of pressure from the community, has agreed to test Primo Baby. The whole country is behind this local story. It would seem that the young Pascal Draney is not giving up her fight to have the blind Primo Baby run in this Sunday's upcoming Calgary Cup.
Hey, Bob. Good.
Yeah. I bet she can't make it around that first set of pylons.
What are you doing here?
Well, it's an Armstrong circus. 200 says she comes unglued halfway through it.
Not betting anymore.
Sure. And cows really do jump over the moon? Give me a break. You and I have been gambling since we were 13 years old. Except for that short break when your mother died.
Get out of here.
Fine. Forget this silly little test of Pascal's. But the stake at the Calgary Cup is at 200 grand. Do some heavy betting. Clean up your debt.
I never charged you interest when you owed me money.
That was a long time ago, Clancy. We've grown up since then.
Okay, baby. Let's get you ready.
Hey, kid. I've been looking for you.
Eddie! So how was Santa Anita?
So, this is the Armstrong dump, huh? You're gonna miss this place now that your pa's getting out.
What are you talking about?
Uh-oh. Stuck my foot in it. Look, kid, I'm sorry. I thought he'd got in touch.
I'm sure he tried, Eddie. I haven't been home much.
Yeah, well, listen, kid. Other than coming up here to give you my support and everything, I was hoping to run into this kid that owes me. Maybe you know him. I'm holding about 2,500 in markers on this kid that lives up this way. Big breeder's son. I've been trying to collect for some time. I just can't lay my hands on him. You get him to pay up, I'll split your 60-40 like the old days.
And take a chance on landing in juvenile court again. No thanks.
Must be nice not to need money anymore.
What's his name?
Balmain. Rob Balmain.
Never heard of him. Say goodbye, Eddie. I got things to do.
Here's the marker. Just in case. See you, kid.
I know this is tedious business, but if it were my money, I'd show a little interest.
Sorry. Okay, you got my undivided. What?
Listen, why don't you just go down to the track? You have been thinking about Pascal all morning.
Yeah, I know. But she created this situation, and I think I have to let her sort it out.
But your being there could give her some support.
Yeah. But then I have to think, how would my supporting her affect Clancy? It's kind of like being stuck between a rock and a hard place, you know?
Yeah.
Let's get some work done.
It's been blessed.
We certainly didn't have much of a choice.
In order to vindicate myself and the racing board's ruling on this matter, I've decided to give Miss Draney the opportunity to pass my own rigid safety standards.
Which, I might add, will be far more demanding than merely galloping a lone steed around a track.
This girl's gonna single-handedly destroy the Armstrong name. Can't believe Charles and Clancy are letting her get away with it.
On your mark, get set, go!
Like a slalom skier.
Show him, Pascal!
This, of course, will test your horse's maneuverability.
Oh, a precaution this training. I expect your horse to conduct himself calmly and stay focused.
God!
You must appreciate that an uncontrolled animal can be very dangerous in a real race. If a pylon tips over, you have, in my mind, killed the jockey or a horse.
Oh, she hit it.
Oh, no, Primo!
Pascal, hang in there!
Get that horse here. You're finished.
In a race of this type, one must take into consideration all the obstacles. The Calgary Cup has to be protected. One split-second mistake, and it could become as dangerous as a steeplechase where great horses and great jockeys have been injured. Even killed.
Way to go!
Eddie, it's Pascal. Listen, Eddie. I need $2,500 by tomorrow noon. Be serious. If Charles is set against the race, he's sure not going to help me with the entry fee. Dad? No, he hasn't been in touch yet. I'm sure he's very busy. Gotta go, Eddie. Lou, sit down. What? We gotta talk.
I'm Polly De Castano. I'm here to see Rob. Thanks.
A lot of your neighborhood, aren't you?
Save it, Slick. This is not a social call.
Obviously. What do you want?
I'll make it real fast. I want the $2,500 you owe Eddie the book.
How the hell did you know? And all this time, I thought you were so pure. Aren't you the guy who didn't want to be friends with me because you thought I was forcing Clancy to gamble?
You've squeezed them long enough. I know you've been charging Clancy interest on that old gambling debt just so you could pay off Eddie the book.
How charming. Now Clancy's got you doing his dirty work. I didn't even know you cared.
Hey, when Clancy started to gamble and go a little crazy after his accident, you should have been the first one to help him. You were his best friend.
Come on, spare me. If you'd been smart, we could have shared in the profits. Instead, you stopped him.
Hey, fork it over and it'll be our secret. Or I'll have to tell your father.
You won't do that.
Yes, I will. I'm Italian.
Well, you've got 1 minute till closing.
It's all there.
Count it.
Polly, bring him in. He's just not paying attention. Just not good enough.
It's not too late to pull him out. Hey, save yourself some money.
Come on, Primo. Let's keep working.
What is it you're trying to prove, anyway?
Could try talking about it.
I don't know. I'm no good at it. Every time I open my thick mouth, I say the wrong thing.
Oh, I think it just takes a little practice.
I think you're either born with it or you're not.
Did you know how to ride a horse the first time you got on one?
I guess not. Person I can really talk to. I suppose a father and son don't have to have a lot in common.
Oh, you've got a lot in common, all right. You both know how to avoid the real issues. He hides behind his computer and you let him. Buying him toys, buying him friends. Letting him have Sego when Primo didn't pan out.
To Primo, this ranch never had a real failure.
Primo isn't a failure. He's doing the best he can. And I think it's time that you stop blaming Clancy for Primo.
Charles? I'm riding under your colors. I hope that's all right. Mind you, I've livened up the silks a little bit.
Clancy's got to be at that race tomorrow. I'm going to go talk to him.
No. I'll do it. Clancy, open up. Damn. Clancy!
Are you okay?
I will be.
You're lighter than I thought.
You're stronger than I thought. Thanks for letting Polly and Sigold train with Primo. That's not exactly the response I was after.
I'm sorry. Never expected it.
Neither did I. Why not?
It's pretty obvious.
The only thing that's obvious is that you don't believe you can be loved. And you hide behind that chair to prove it.
I've never done anything that turned out right.
You watched us train today.
If Primo can't beat Saygold, he will never beat Pewter Force.
He may not win, but he has the right to run. You bred him to race.
You'll just make a fool out of him.
Or you?
Pascal? I have to be alone right now.
Your father needs you at that race. Primo and I need you.
Looking good, Polly.
Woo! Look at you.
Take Saygold in.
Why are you so dressed up?
Come on, Primo.
It's in Primo's honor. Maybe a tiny bit for Charles.
I guess everybody will be betting on Pewter Force today.
Pewter Force? No, I'm putting my money on Primo and Saygold.
Good afternoon, ladies and gentlemen, and welcome to Calgary Cup Futurity today at Stampede Park. Ideal weather conditions today. The track will be rated as fast. It's now 30 minutes to close time.
I'm about to break your toes. First, I found out you used all my raw Balmain money to enter Primo. As if that isn't bad enough, I find out that the horse is blind. Then this morning, I find out that the horse has nobody riding him. Who the hell is Napoleon
De Castano.
Whatever.
Trust me, Eddie. Polly can ride.
The word is that Primo had an okay practice run this morning. But, kid, not being able to see is a fair problem.
What did you used to tell me it took to win?
Guts.
You don't think it took guts for that horse to take one step after the other? Look at the odds on him, Eddie. You'll make a fortune off him if he even shows.
If I lose, kid, you're going to be walking on your hands the rest of your life.
I almost forgot. Your old man's here today.
My father? Did you see him? Where is he?
He's at the grandstand, placing bets.
Dad! Dad!
Excuse me?
Hey, kid. It's good thing the cops aren't after me. Just inform the whole world that I'm here.
Is there a mother that goes along with this child?
Hey, babe, this is my good friend, Betty. Hey, this is my one and only kid, Pascal.
Guess you've been pretty busy lately.
I tried to get to see you, but I had all this business to look after. Just haven't had time. Hey, you're doing pretty good without me. Eddie says you got a horse running today.
You betting on him?
I'm surprised. Kind of goes against what I taught you.
We don't bet on losers.
Pewter Force is the big news. I got 2-1 on him.
I think I can get you a job at the ranch.
Oh, well, say, that's just wonderful.
You know, Betty has some family things to clear up here in town, and then maybe we can head out that way.
Gotta be getting back to my horse.
How old is she?
She's 13. Or 15? I don't know.
I guess I won't be needing this anymore.
Call you.
You can't be serious. A ranch in Alberta?
Sagal's in great shape, Norman. We better get out there. I'll see you two at the paddock.
Okay.
Now I'm gonna head up to the jocks room.
Polly!
Thanks. Oh, Dad.
All right, kiddo?
Of course. Why wouldn't I be?
Think it's safe to let him run?
You're not worried about Primo's safety. All you care about is Sagal.
Is Pewter Force really the top bet today?
I didn't come this far to ride a loose. Pewter Force is easily the best racehorse on this track.
Where are the security guards? I asked those guys not to take their eyes off this horse.
Well, I want to spend a few moments with Sagold. I let him go. Primo screws up his chances.
Then why are you letting Pascal race him?
Because it's so important to her.
I heard her father's here today. Maybe she'll go back.
Is that what you want?
Her father's a convict.
I was first considering Pascal. I didn't know much about her background. Other than the fact that she just loved to be around horses. It wasn't until I went to bring her home that I found out her dad was in jail. I don't know. I guess I felt she shouldn't have to suffer for her father's mistakes.
You're amazing. You can forgive a perfect stranger, but you can't forgive your own son.
What are you talking about?
The accident.
I don't want to talk about it again.
Again? We've never talked about it. You've always blamed me for that accident.
It's me I've been blaming, son. I should have had more compassion for your mother. I just didn't want to believe she was so addicted to gambling. That night when she called from the racetrack. God. I told her that I'd leave her if she didn't quit. I don't know why I said that.
It was the first time I saw Mom drunk. She wouldn't let me drive.
What do you mean? Police report said you were driving.
I lied.
Oh, God.
Dad, is gambling hereditary?
All I know is admitting it is the first step, man. After that, you have to let people who love you to help you. I didn't do a very good job with your mother. I've just been so afraid of messing up with you, too. Please. Let me help, huh? Mm-hmm.
Weren't you intimidated when you found out how stiff the competition really was?
Oh, I'm not worried. I'm Italian.
And isn't it true the racing secretary wouldn't allow Pascal to ride Primo?
Wrong. Well, I could have ridden Primo, but Poli has more experience. He's a better and lighter rider.
We understand Charles Armstrong took you in as his foster child. Don't you think your actions seriously harm the reputation of his ranch?
What? About the only thing it could hurt is my daughter's pride. Come on.
Riders up. Horses are now leaving the paddock area.
You know, it's not too late to back out if you have to. I really want you to do the best thing for that horse.
And for me?
Go get him.
The horses are now on the track. It's 8 months to Pulpstone. Number one is the favorite Pewter Force, written by Defino, owned by the Balmain Stable. Number two is Simple Millions, owned by the Calgary Cattle Company. Number three, Seagull, written by Norm Jewell, trained by Ann Williams, owned by the Armstrong Ranches. Number four, Dark Fighter, owned by Ted Holmes, trained by Jack Ross. Number 10 is Finish Early, the rider is Alicia Smith. Number seven, Jockey DiCostano, is keeping Primo Baby well back in the pack. And that's the field, ladies and gentlemen.
If Seagull does anything to harm Pewter Force, I'll be collecting more than just...
Rob. Seagull's breeding wouldn't allow her to act any less than the lady she is, on or off the track.
Sweetheart, what's the matter?
Field is there in the starting gate. The horses are now starting to be loaded. They are having some problems here, I see, with number seven, Primo Baby, who is reluctant to go in the starting gate. There he has just hit his head, Jockey Dick.
He's not right. There's something wrong.
Now he's got to move back up again, now in behind the gate. Now he's in.
We got to get him out of there. He'll get hurt.
It's just too late.
Here up the post.
Can he?
I don't think so.
Just to keep up, Seagull seems to be easing up. It appears Norm Jewell is holding back on Seagull. Looks like Seagull dropping back.
I think he's letting him get away from Seagull.
Seagull and Seagull are now beginning to pull breath.
Come on, you just let yourself the world's fastest thing. I don't let go.
It's Pewter Force still on the lead.
And here they come. They're up the head of the lane, an eighth of a mile to go.
Kill him!
Fuck!
Primo. I'm real proud of you.
A friend who'll always remain.
I know, right.
I know. Love is the answer.
Thanks.
You said.
Congratulations.
Thank you.
You'd stay forever. Reach out.
Reach out.
For what you believe.
Got Kentucky Derby material here?
Hey, Triple Crown. Yeah.
Days filled with loneliness, I was blinded by my knees.
Congratulations, son.
So I had to go beyond my limits to find what.